All right, next quote is from Howard Zinn himself.
Patriotism does not mean simply obeying your government. That's not what patriotism is. Patriotism is supporting the principles for which your government is supposed to stand. And when your government goes against those principles include caring about life and liberty and the pursuit of happiness for everybody, when your government goes against those principles, your government is being unpatriotic. And then it's your patriotic duty to oppose your government.
And that's exactly what I've been doing. The Cambridge City government and the state of Massachusetts, and the United States government, and Cambridge Community Television, which is funded mostly by city money, have been abusing me, and I'm an American citizen, my freedom as an American, because they harass me because they think I'm mentally ill. Now, that's a violation of discrimination statutes, but it's also First Amendment violations. And this is the government. They don't see themselves as the government, these people at Cambridge Community Television, but they're paid by government funds. They are effectively public officials. They're called special public officials under the statutes. But that's not how they see themselves, you see? So when they harass me, they think they can do it because they're individuals exercising their free speech rights. But they don't understand they're exercising government power. And that's a First Amendment violation. So I'm the one that's standing up against them, but that's not how they see it. And this program here is all liberals attacking the conservatives for silencing when the government abuses their thing. Be patriotic and speak out. Defend the Constitution. That's what I do all the time. City Council never talks about the Constitution. They're the ones that prioritize racism, sexism, and homophobia over other forms of discrimination. I mean, this is outright unlawful activities by the City Council and Cambridge Community Television. All right, this next clip is from Barbosa.
The important is that the only patriotic duty is to find peace and justice for all parties included. In whatever conflict we seem to have or that our government is creating.
Well, he says that we should find peace and justice for all parties, but that's not what they do. They're interested in peace and justice for black people, gays, and women, and a few select other countries who have problems, like El Salvador, and later on you hear about some attempt to help some African country, the Sister City Project. I mean, think about this. Cambridge City Council says, hey, we have eight sister cities. They want to make 9 or 10 of them. There's people living out in the streets, and they use city taxpayer funds to fly to Japan, to fly to Cuba, to go have dinner and live in first-rate hotels. We're going to create a sister city project while people live out in the streets in Cambridge. This is the priorities of the Cambridge City Council and these liberals here. All right, this next comment is from Reverend Tobin and followed by Howard Zinn about censorship and boycott.
Sort of a society of intimidated people.
Mm-hmm.
I think that there are ways that folks are punished in this society if they mm-hmm. go against the grain.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very hard, especially for media. WBR, for example, has lost something like $2 million from sponsors because they've been accused of being pro-Palestinian. That's punishment.
Yeah.
And it worked in some instances. The same thing's true with other kinds of media. So I think it's very hard, and they don't really want oftentimes to risk their establishment.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, despite that, and it's an enormous obstacle to overcome, you know, what you're talking about, this control of the media, this punishment that's meted out to people who step out of line. What?
You know, he's talking about conservatives punishing people that step out of line, the liberals. But these are liberals that run Cambridge Community Television attacking me because I'm criticizing them, because they don't like what I say. So the liberals do the exact same thing, and these are liberals blaming the conservatives. And they talk about boycotting. What about Laura Schlesinger? That was the gays boycotting Laura Schlesinger. They almost hounded her off the air, and they're complaining about boycotts. Well, the same thing is done by both sides, you see. They see it's okay for them, but nobody else to do the same thing. It's just incredible, the hypocrisy of these people. Here's Harris now.
I suppose it should encourage us to, you know, to keep going, keep spreading the word. I suppose what it suggests is that maybe that the truth is more powerful
mm-hmm.
than the propaganda put out by the government,
mm-hmm.
and that it can have an effect.
Yes, Howard, that's exactly what keeps me going, that if the truth is stronger than the propaganda, I will overcome this liberal propaganda totalitarian group that runs Cambridge Community Television and the city of Cambridge. That's exactly what keeps me going, Howard, the search for truth, because these people don't want to hear the truth. They want to censor anybody who disagrees with them. All they're interested in is in their liberal propaganda, their ultra-leftist propaganda, and they're intolerant, abusing city funds, taxpayer funds, for their own personal interests. This next clip is Joan Harris now.
A different story. Other, as you're saying, everyone else knows what's going on but us. ISIS is everywhere else, but not here. And we truly are deprived. Americans are deprived of what is going on. We don't know what is true.
That doesn't seem to stop her from talking, did it? Saying that she didn't know what was true. The next clip is Howard Zinn about giving money to the United Nations to get their support.
No.
But, you know, the UN is dominated by a small number of nations. And those nations, as you say, are beholden to the United States. The United States dangles bribes in front of them.
Okay.
And that's how it got support in the first Gulf War in the UN. You know, it gave billions of dollars to Egypt, gave large sums of money to other countries to get their vote in the UN to support the war.
Yeah, that's the United States did that. They got Egypt to vote for them in the United Nations. And Harvard and MIT, they give money to the politicians at the state level and the city council. And guess who else? At CCTV. I got an email. They took my my video down from the website here. They said they had too much, it was taking up too much space. Before, when they first put it up, they said unlimited space on the internet. They had no limit. All of a sudden, my video about Harvard, criticizing Harvard, showing Harvard lying, had came down. And the same day I was notified of that, guess who I saw on the street? David Zawinski, who's their vice president in charge of planning. Is that a coincidence or what? I mean, I don't deny being paranoid, but there's just too much coincidence going on around here. Where you have everybody, Harvard psychiatrists, and all these morons that work for the FBI, they don't leave me alone. This is just unbelievable. Maybe we got time for one more clip. This is from Barbosa, and let's hear what he has to say.
The implications in our neighborhoods, Mo, in terms of how this is affecting young people around us or people from immigrant populations, I'm just curious.
Something came to mind as I was actually thinking about today is there's a superintendent in New Jersey who started labeling the students in his school system as terrorists. We've taken this language that is actually being used, you know, incorrectly everywhere else in the world, and that our country is using it incorrectly towards people outside the country. Now we're starting to use it incorrectly.
Okay, he's talking about the use of terrorism. Well, people use mental illness for the same reasons that he talks about using the word terrorism. People are intolerant, they don't like what somebody says, they designate a mentally ill, and they start harassing him with police, and they people here at Cambridge Community Television, of all people, liberals, allegedly compassionate liberals concerned with discrimination, abuse, people they think are mentally ill, and disabled people in general. They're just one big word called hypocrite. It's the Greek word means to act. In any case, I'm Roy Burkhoff. This is Enough Room, and hopefully this will be rebroadcast tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. and again at midnight. In any case, you know we have free cash back here on Cambridge Community Television. And if you send $2 in, you get $1 back. And remember, Enough Room is fat-free. There is no cholesterol. See you next time.